Vaccines help protect us from diseases that can potentially kill us, like measles, polio, and even the mumps. Even when people opt out of vaccines, they can still provide fringe benefits for the rest of us, especially for people who aren't eligible for certain vaccines, like pregnant women and infants. In fact, you can effectively eliminate a disease without vaccinating every person. But why would that be? The answer lies in something called herd immunity. When you hear herd, you may think of a clutch of cows, or maybe a band of buffalo. And we know that if a lion is closing in for the kill, a single buffalo may be safer because he's part of the herd. In a similar way, you are safer when most of the people around you have immunity to a disease. At its most basic level, think about how you get sick. When a contagious disease enters into an unvaccinated group, sickness can spread rapidly. This is because there's no immunity to the disease in the group. If most people, the herd, have been immunized, then you get some indirect protection. Thanks to them, it's less likely you'll come into contact with someone who has the virus. That's herd immunity at work. But when a larger number of people have no immunity, you're out of luck. You have less people to shield you. As early as the 19th century, a British epidemiologist named William Farr noticed this phenomenon with smallpox. Now it's recognized as a key tool to prevent disease outbreaks. So how many people must be vaccinated to keep you safe? It really depends on the disease. For measles, scientists think about 94% of the population. For other diseases, like smallpox and diphtheria, scientists think it's closer to 85%. So that's why vaccines play such a central role in protecting populations. For once, it's best not to be special. Here's to being part of the herd. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm Dina Fine Maron. Thank you.